Were other names considered for Yukon Striker?
Oh yeah, the naming process is quite an exercise. So we go through lots of time to get the name.
Will the ride close early due to fireworks?
If the fireworks continue to be in this area, then obviously they'll close early. We're still looking through that.
Is construction ahead or behind at the current moment?
Construction's on schedule.
What happens in the tunnel when there is a downpour?
Well, obviously the tunnel's open on both ends, so the rain will come in. So rain finds its way to the bottom here. We've got a pump pit at the other end, and the pump will drain the water out of the tunnel.
Have there been any challenges so far?
In any construction project there are challenges. So building inside of a pond in an active floodway is a challenge. But, you know, we also had the ice storm that we dealt with back in May, or in April, and then the windstorm in May. Those were two challenges we had to deal with. But other than that, everything's been as predicted.
When did planning for a dive coaster start for Wonderland?
We started in 2013, maybe 2012. It was quite some time ago. It was before Skyrider was removed.
Okay. Makes sense. And when is construction slated to be completed?
Final completion will be sometime in April. We don't have a firm date on that, but it'll be for the public opening, obviously.
Is there going to be any special effects in the tunnel?
Nothing that I want to talk about today.
Okay. What was Wonderland looking for when approaching B&M for Yukon Striker? What were their requirements or asked, must-haves?
Well, we wanted to have the tunnel, obviously, and we wanted to integrate it with Vortex. We wanted to have a loop, and we wanted to have something that was thrilling, something that had never been done before. So four inversions and the height and the length, and I think it'll be a good ride.
Is there anything unique about Yukon Striker's trains that we don't know about?
I don't think so. I think they're basically the same as Valrayman trains.
What's it like working with B&M? Because we know the park works with B&M quite a bit.
Yeah, they're great. They're a very reputable manufacturer and supplier of ride equipment. So we enjoy working with them.
Thank you.
expect the Midway and entrance to be Canada's Wonderland's best yet, or any further insight on the Midway and entrance for Yukon Striker?
Best is a subjective term. It's different for every person, right?
Yeah.
So we're planning it to be appropriate and to be fitted into what the ride is. The ride's impressive, so we want the area to match. I don't think we'll do any surprises with it. It'll be what people expect.
All right. So any insight on what the station will look like?
The station will be themed to Frontier Canada, Gold Rush of 1890.
Anything we don't know about Yukon Striker?
It's hard to know what you already know or what you don't know. So that's a tough question to answer.
Is there anything that maybe hasn't been announced yet for Yukon Striker in the POVs and stuff?
No, there's a few other things that we're going to add that we'll leave as a surprise. But yeah, that'll come later. They're not going to be substantial. They'll be minor. We'll be right back.
are the footings for the tallest part of the ride?
They're all about 8 meters. So the design was 8 meters. Obviously, when we do our coring of the earth, we look for soil conditions, and if the soil conditions don't meet our needs, then we have to go a little deeper, but they're all around 8 meters.
Any insight on Frontier Canada and what we maybe can expect?
Frontier Canada has been a phased build over the years, and that phased approach will continue even beyond Yukon Striker. So it'll just be more of the same. Actually, the theme of this ride and the surrounding area will continue to be in that vein. It'll be a multi-year.
When did planning for Frontier Canada start?
That planning started in 1980, before Wonderland opened. We've been, One Mighty Canadian Mind Buster was one of the first attractions for Frontier Canada. And Frontier Canada was planned to have other attractions, but that didn't happen, and now we're back into the Frontier Canada plan. Or continuation of Frontier Canada. Whitewater Canyon's part of it, Timber Falls is part of it, Flying Canoes, Soaring Timbers, Flying Lumberjack, Canyon Trader. All of those attractions are part of that area.
So when did Cedar Fair decide to revisit the concept?
I guess it was with Soaring Timbers. Yeah, I think it was with Soaring Timbers. So 2016? 2017, I guess.